Today we are very fortunate to have our not only donors, keynote speakers, as well as the SWE partners who are on this call. 14 practitioners who are here. We are all working under extremely difficult situations today. All of us, we wish to be safe, our communities to be safe, and also our employees to be safe. However, safe working is one of the most important aspects of what we do and work day and night for.
Congratulations to Safe Water Network for having organized this webinar event in a situation which is very appropriate, as the captain mentions. Water being a key component of our lives. The key component of this particular project, Seva, is to support people such as who are on the webinar, people who are small water enterprises and who are willing to be small water enterprises, or people who have graduated to other water sector issues. How we can basically strengthen this alliance?
I personally feel that the work being done by the Safe Water Network is something very important, a laudable effort. And you have been, I think, working in more than 17 states. And you are definitely, you know, joining hands with the government, assisting the governments, basically, and you know, filling up the gaps of the drinking water to the people. And the quality of water, as I mentioned, that I myself seen in both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, being supplied by these safe networks are really good. And the success of this webinar, as well as the success of your efforts, which you have been doing in the country. Thank you very much.
Yeah, we would like to have a space of Seva as a representation of small water and water sector representatives to be a part of your, advisory role. When you're basically doing think tanks, when you're basically having policies, when you're doing anything, please feel free to call upon the Seva team, because this is what we need. This is what we are asking from people like you, that we our voice should actually go beyond just what we are doing in our own communities. So that's just a humble request, that we just wanted to do this through your participation. Secondly, USAID is also partnering with Niti Aayog on various fronts, be it corporate sector, be it other elements of what we are doing. So I'm very glad that you basically took the time and spoke out on the sector that is relevant to the thing. Once again, thank you very much, sir.
Rule the roost in the medium to long term. So far, there has been a healthy adversarial position between the centralized and the decentralized systems globally. And if you look at the slide right now, you'll notice that the decentralized business, which was almost at an abysmal level almost a decade ago, is today in excess of $20 billion in sheer size of business opportunity. My view or sense is, as I indicated on the previous slide, that will set the stage for a growth of the decentralized model, which in any case is a very comprehensive and a contained supply chain in a catchment area. So I believe supply chain will more gravitate towards the decentralized model. On the dispensation environment standpoint, the pre-COVID era assumed that water is safe, which it indeed was. However, now it has to be beyond water, because not only water, even the containers and the vessels in which water is contained, or other paraphernalia around the dispensation environment, will have to be cleansed.
Hey, my name is Minhaj and I run Drinkwell. So we're actually based in Calcutta, and we are a technology provider primarily focused on addressing the arsenic and fluoride water crisis.
A services approach under which we would like to harness existing capacities. You know, so we've built an electric vehicle model for delivery of safe water around every ATM. And we've built a very high-end tech platform that collects data in the real time.
So the first and foremost thing is to ensure that they are following the highest protocols of safety and well-being and are not adversely affected in any manner. And that's extremely important to ensure throughput. providing the right equipment, but also ensuring that they are trained and geared up in order to be able to do that.
During this time, like many people have thought what we should do, we have established some of the new products which were required for our running a water station and also for the COVID, post-COVID, with our channel partners. Especially that you can see here in the photograph, the disinfectant tunnel and the contactless sanitizer, which I believe is going to be in great demand, and also the back paper sanitizer. And we also encourage our operators' families to develop masks, stitching of masks. So we are now in a position to supply masks also.
We are a Hyderabad-based social enterprise formed under the Make in India initiative. And we have developed an alternative technology which generates potable water by harvesting the humidity in the atmosphere, as a result of which we can give water on a sustainable basis even in places where there is no water available. Now, our product Meghdoot has already been approved and recognized by the Ministry of Jal Shakti through the Marshalkar Committee.
Nandi Water has been working for the last 10 years with the mission to save lives of underserved communities by providing access to safe drinking water in a sustainable manner. We are in 7 states, set up about 650 water centers, providing water to 7.5 lakh people every day and 50,000 school children. We also believe the most sustainable way of operating a water center is if you're able to run it, train people in the communities and then hand it back to them for them to manage it themselves.
We are working on electrolytic technologies through partners like NIRI and other CSIR labs. We are working on nanotechnologies through partners like Drinkwell. And we have in our installations in the most hardest of water qualities in India. We have fluoride removal plant with the highest fluoride content in West Bengal. We have RO plant in Rajasthan with the TDS is as high as 17,000 and so on. As far as COVID-19 strategies are concerned, since we are working with most of the rural water supply authorities, so I would like to say they have been very cooperative in terms of issuing passes. So that's how we were able to manage some of our ATMs, you know, to be operational during these periods. The district magistrates, the collectors, they were helping us to issue the passes in right amount of right time, and that's why we were able to keep almost 50-60% of our installations running.
So we started our journey in 2008, pretty much similar to what Parag started, and we are operating in about 20 states currently. We have over 1,750 touch points. And we serve close to about now 700,000 on a daily basis. We started using what is called the Internet of Things even before the sort of term was coined way back in 2008. So we've been leveraging technology quite heavily. We also are very proud to say that we were the first proponents of introducing the water ATM as a concept.
We brought in a lot of IoTization in this entire paraphernalia of water. We brought in analytics in the entire paraphernalia. So that made our life much more better in terms of ensuring whether my plants are running or not, how I could do maintenance, and how I can bring about a sea change of things.
We have dispensed about 110 million liters of water in the last 75 days. So, we, you know, from a perspective of COVID, yes, we were affected, but I would say that effect has been about 10 to 15% in our large format machines or in the communities where we sell the maximum amount of volumes, and that has brought in a reduction in the number of customers who are coming out. But nevertheless, the good part is that we still are operational. We still are able to serve a large number of our consumers on a daily basis.
And once the COVID is settled, maybe we'll collect the money or recharge the card. So as of now, only operator card is being used to prevent it. And another thing, you know, a lot of awareness is being done with our water committee in the village. And interestingly, some our water plants are owned by the community, and many villages have profits. 50,000, 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 5 lakh. You know, one of our water plant have 17 lakh rupee net profit in their account. So villages who have profits, they came forward to contribute for the situation.
I am very grateful to my team who are competent technically, commercially, and otherwise. They are training all our people to digitizing the consumer to a business. All our consumers are on also now being brought to the Bheem or UPI, this thing. We are also aware that our volumes will not be what they were, but we are ensuring continuity through remote service capability. We are also focusing on operator health so that they do not impact the health of the water. And we are focusing more on water quality in this. One of our partners and donors, Underwriters Laboratory, keep a very, very close vigil. We are being supported very heartily by Honeywell, who are giving all the support for COVID countering in all these stations. And we are bringing power of one, in the sense one technician can do mechanical, electrical training and servicing, which are all local. Similarly, operator is being trained on local repairs. We are also working on seeing what other things can be run on this platform and how can we increase the awareness.
Our webinar has been extremely actually useful, very educative, and particularly the people have mentioned about their, you know, their entrepreneurship and the service, particularly during the COVID time, they have provided to the people. So in the end, I will just again sum up with only one line, saying that probably the COVID has given an opportunity for our entrepreneurs to, you know, go much more aggressively on this, because the people will definitely prefer to have the water from the filling stations rather than, purchasing the water. Thank you so much.
Small Water Enterprise Alliance, I would like to thank Dr. Ashok Jain, Mr. Anand Rudra, our donors Honeywell and Pentair, all our very esteemed and illustrious panelists and the participants. Thank you very much for being with us. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
Very grateful to each one of you. Thank you very much. Thank you.